If my mother was here now, she would say it is dirty. It is a dirty day. That is what she would say, because we are having grey, cloudy, windy, wet weather. And my mum would always say that that type of weather means the day is very dirty. So we are having a dirty day here in England today. Here we are again. English Addict is back with you, coming to you live from the birthplace of the English language, which is, you know where it is. It is England. It is England, everyone. That is where I am. Right now, I am here in England, live on YouTube. This is not a recording, unless, of course, you are watching the recording. But this now, right now, at 6 minutes past 2 o'clock on a Wednesday afternoon, it is English Addict with myself. Hi, everybody. My name is Mr. Duncan. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope you are feeling good today. I'm not too bad, even though the weather is really horrible. I wanted to go for a walk this morning, but it's windy. We're having loads of rain. Between you and me, I am absolutely fed up of the rain, because we seem to be having a lot of rain. I can't wait for the lovely long dry days of summer, to be honest with you. My name is Duncan, and I am a fan of the English language. You might say that I am an English addict, and I have a feeling maybe perhaps you are one of those as well. Here we are again. Can I say a big hello to the YouTube algorithms? Once again, I can almost hear those computers in California. Those computers are all going, no, Mr. Duncan, no, 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 no one is going to see you. Thank you very much once again to YouTube and the lovely algorithms. Here we are again, English Addict. Thank you for joining me. It's very nice to see you. I know what you're going to say. Mr. Duncan, you have to do more to promote your YouTube channel. I don't know what else I can do, to be honest with you. I really don't know. Anyway, enough of that. I'm here, you're here, and that, I suppose, is all that matters. For those who are looking for my new YouTube channel, I have had some problems with it, so it has vanished. I have another plan. All will be revealed over the next couple of days. Hello to the live chat. Hello to Vitas and also Beatrice. You were both first on today's live chat. I do like the race that always happens at the start of today's or any live stream, is when we try to get the fastest finger on the mouse. So today we have Vitas and also Beatrice as well. Hello also to, oh, he is here, Luis Mendez is here today. Hello, Luis. Nice to see you also. Christina is here. We also have Maritz. Hello to you as well. Thank you for joining me today. Claudia is here as well. Alexandro. Hello, Alexandro. Nice to see you here as well. I am looking at the live chat right now. If you want to say hello, if you want to say hello, Mr. Duncan, maybe it is your first time. Maybe you have never, ever typed anything on the live chat before. Perhaps it is your first time. Don't be shy. Give it a try. You never know. You might actually enjoy it. And I know what it feels like, because sometimes I also watch live streams of different things, live events, like the eclipse. Did you see that? Did you see the live coverage all over the internet? Hundreds of thousands of people were watching the eclipse. It came, it went. Some people said that the end of the world would occur. Guess what? It didn't. We're still here to enjoy all of this. Hello also, Avandro. Hello, Avandro here as well. So, please let me know. Say something on the live chat. Maybe you can say, hello, Mr. Duncan. It's okay. I think that's good. That's a good thing to say, to be honest with you. I am here today. We have an interesting subject, change. Changes. Express the change. Changes. Things change all the time. Even the English language, you might not even realize it, because over the years, English has changed as a language. Lots of things change the way words are used. Certain words come into fashion and other words slowly disappear. They vanish without trace. A bit like me on YouTube, when you think about it. So we are talking about change, the way in which things can change, alter. Maybe the appearance of something, maybe the shape. Maybe the height of something, maybe the depth of something, maybe the length of something. You can make it longer, you can make it shorter, you can make it higher, you can make it deeper. All of those things we are talking about today with the subject of making changes. And I think sometimes in life, I think it is good to make changes. We don't like it. So that is another truth of life. We don't like change, but sometimes it is good to make changes. It keeps everything new, fresh, exciting. Maybe something you've always wanted to try and you've been afraid of doing it. Maybe you want to change a certain thing about yourself. Perhaps you want to change your style of clothing. Maybe you want to wear something bright and colourful. Something like that, perhaps. Make a change to your house, maybe. Maybe you can make a change to your routine, the way you do things during the day. So I think making changes is a good thing. Changing anything, in fact. That is what we are talking about today. Hello, Idris. Idris, hello to you. Nice to see you on the live chat. Proving that I do say hello. Give it a try. You never know. You might enjoy it. Don't forget, if you like this, please give me a lovely like. Because, well, to be honest with you, I'm not going to lie, I'm a bit desperate. I'm in a desperate situation. No one wants to be in a desperate situation. And it is not something I normally mention, but I am in a desperate situation. Trying new things. Hopefully, those new things will work. Sometimes you have to change things because you need a change of direction. Maybe the thing you are doing isn't very good, or maybe the thing you are doing is not interesting. So you have to try and make it a little more exciting. Hello, Renee. Renee Paredes Chacon. I hope I pronounce your name correctly. Renee, a big hello to you. Thank you very much for joining me. Angela as well. Good afternoon, Mr. Duncan. Hello, Angela. Nice to see you here on the live chat as well. Thank you very much. Do not be shy. Give it a try. or else she will make Mr. Duncan cry. We are looking at the way things have changed. We are looking at the way things can change. Something you can do, perhaps, to change part of your life. A lot of people these days, I have noticed something that people are doing a lot, more than they used to. And this is not just women, but also men as well. They are changing their face. It's true. Now, one thing I've always said, one thing I've always thought of when I think about getting older, I don't think I will ever have cosmetic surgery or anything to change the shape or the appearance of my face. But I have noticed these days a lot of people are, because, well, certainly from my own experience of living here in England, it is possible now to have cosmetic surgery in many places. So you don't just have to go to a special hospital or a special doctor. You can actually go to many places now, and they will do things to make your appearance look, I was going to say better, but I don't think it always makes your face look better. I suppose one of the big trends at the moment is to inject Botox. I'm coughing at the moment. Just a moment. I will be back. I'll be back in a second. Sure, I'm on the way out. I think so. Maybe I should see a doctor. Well, that was interesting. I'm very sorry about that. I had a little tickle in my throat. But at least we got to see the cows. As I was saying just before my throat rudely interrupted me, a lot of people these days are making changes to their appearance, their face. The face is something that I suppose is very public when you walk out. Everyone can see what you look like. But a big trend at the moment is to have Botox injections in your face to make it look, well, I want to say that some people think it makes them look better. But to be honest with you, I don't think it does. We have a great phrase in English. Sometimes it is good to grow old gracefully. If you grow old gracefully, it means you are growing old with a little bit of dignity. So you are not trying to hide your age. So maybe perhaps some people don't want to do that. They want to try and hold back the appearance of getting older. To be honest with you, it doesn't really worry me too much. I suppose my biggest fear is health. So if my health got worse or became worse as I grew older, then I would definitely be worried. But as far as my appearance is concerned, I'm not too worried, if I was honest with you. And yes, I am 60 next year. I still can't believe it. I was saying to Mr. Steve the other night, I can't believe that next year, not this year, but next year, 2025, I will be 60. And it doesn't feel like it. I don't feel as if I am approaching 60, if I was honest with you. It doesn't feel like it at all. Can I say hello to, oh, Christina. Hello, Christina. Nice to see you here as well. Yes, I'm feeling all right now. I don't know what happened. My throat was very dry. One of the problems with doing this in this type of environment is quite often your throat will become very sore and very dry because of the heat in the room. Anyway, enough about that. My new channel has been delayed, but I will actually be posting some new videos here on my YouTube channel, the one you are watching now. So all of the new lessons that I was going to put on my new channel, I will now be putting on this channel to make it easier for those who want to find them. So that is what I will be doing. Hello to podcasts by Krish. Hello, Krish. Nice to see you here. What type of podcast do you do? Is it a particular subject? And this is the big thing nowadays. A lot of people are doing podcasts. When we think of podcasts, we often think of a short thing, a short discussion, conversation. Quite often it is just audio. So there is no picture, just audio. So you will listen to a podcast. However, nowadays, of course, because video and live streaming is so popular, especially on sites like this one, you will find a lot of people now do their podcasts in vision as well. So not only can you hear the person or the people, you can see them as well. And there are many very popular podcasters on YouTube. Thank you very much. Hello, Niha. Niha, who says Happy Eid. Happy Eid to you as well. Who else is here today? Stuti. Stuti. Hello, Stuti. That is a very interesting name. Hello to you. Thank you for joining as well. No, I am not doing any podcasts yet. I only give my name. I only gave that name to my channel. Well, maybe you could start a podcast. Maybe you could do something. A lot of people are. It's become very popular. All you need is a microphone and a computer and one of these. And that's it, really. How can I learn to speak English? Well, I have some great new videos coming up very soon all about learning English. For those who are learning, those who are starting or beginning their journey into the world of learning English. So that is what is going on my channel, and that is a very good way of improving your English. Listen, learn, and also don't be afraid to speak as well. Listen, learn, speak. Or listen, read, learn, and speak. Quite often when you're learning something, you find that certain ways of doing it will be more suitable for you. So some people might like to learn in a particular way, a certain type of way, whilst others might choose a different way or a different method. So it does depend on your own situation. So we have today's subject coming up, and we have also some discussion about making changes, changing things. What do we use in English when we are talking about changing the shape, changing the height, changing the way something appears? All of that coming up in a moment. Thank you. We have had so much rain, and to be honest with you, I'm a little bit fed up of the rain. I can't wait until summer arrives. Welcome. English Addict is with you right now, live on YouTube, 26 minutes past 2 o'clock, as I stand here in my little studio in Much Wenlock in England. Thank you very much for joining me today. We have a big subject. Now, this might be a subject that a lot of people are interested in, something that we all have to do, I would say, quite often in life. We often have to make changes. And I think change is something that is constant. The word constant means ever present. Something that is always around. It is constant. It is something that is always there. Change and life quite often go together, because every day there is a new challenge, something you have to do, something you have to change, something you have to alter. So that is what we are talking about today. We are talking about making changes. And I suppose the first thing I should do is talk about the word itself. So when we talk about making changes, you might change something. The first word, change. You might alter something. If you alter something, it means you are making something different. You are maybe changing something in a certain way. You change that thing. You alter that thing. Perhaps you have an item of clothing that is too big or too small. You have to make changes so it will fit you. We alter the clothes. Amend. Amend also means change. Maybe you are changing something you are unhappy with. Maybe something you want to correct. Or maybe something you want to put right. You amend that thing. We have redesign. Redesign means to make something look different. Quite often as an improvement. So we often think of something being improved when we redesign something. Quite often with technology, you will often find technology is always being redesigned. It is changed. It is improved, which is the next word. To improve something is to change, normally for the better. You are improving something. And finally, you might refigure. To refigure is to make changes, to put one thing in a different place. Maybe you will move things around, you will swap things over. To refigure something, you are making something different, you are making it look different, you are making changes. There are many ways of expressing certain types of change. For example, we have lessen. Now, the sound of this word does sound like a period of learning. A lesson is a period of learning. However, if you look here, the spelling is very different. To lessen something is to decrease. You are making something less, to make less. You lessen something. You reduce the amount or the number of something. You lessen. Maybe you are in pain and you take some medicine or some tablets to lessen the pain. You are trying to make that pain go away, or at least you are trying to make that pain less than it is. And then, of course, we have the opposite, which is increase. So to increase is a type of change where you make something more. You increase something. So again, it is a type of change. To lessen is to make less. To increase is to make more. Maybe you increase your productivity. Maybe you work harder. You increase. Maybe you lessen your pain. Maybe you have a pain in your neck or in your back, like I do. You want to make it less. So those are types of change. Here's another one. Shrink. Shrink. To shrink something. Maybe it will shrink. It will become smaller. It can happen. Even parts of your body sometimes can shrink. Grow. Something becomes larger. Shrink becomes smaller. The change is that. Grow is that. The opposite. Something grows. Something gets larger. Maybe a person will grow as they mature. A person will grow a beard. Maybe your features will change because of something you've done. You might grow a mustache on your face. Something might shrink. Maybe you have a big boil on your neck. But over time, it will get smaller. It will shrink. It will become less and less. They are both types of change. Reduce. To reduce means to make less. You reduce something. There are many ways of expressing reduce. To make less. Maybe you reduce the amount of hours that you work. Maybe you work 20 hours a week. Imagine that. But you want to reduce the amount of hours that you work to 12, which sounds good to me, I have to say. Maybe you need to work more. Maybe you have to work longer. Then you will increase that thing. You will work more. You will work longer. So reduce means to make less, and increase, make more. They are both types of change which can occur in life. Lower. You can lower something. Something that is maybe too high or too tall, you might lower that thing. You can also lower the amount of money you pay someone for their work. You lower that thing. You make it less. To lower something is to make something less than it was. You might also decrease the height of something. So something is very tall and you want to make it shorter. You lower something. You make it less high. The opposite, of course, is heighten. You heighten something. You increase the height of that thing. You make that thing higher or taller. You make it much higher or much lower. Higher, lower. You lower something, you heighten something. You make it higher. Here's another one. Shorten. You shorten something. You decrease the length. So something that's long and something that you want to make shorter. You shorten something. We can also talk about time as well. Time can be long or short. So maybe you want to work for less time. Maybe you don't want to do your work all the time, or maybe you are always feeling tired. You can shorten your work hours. You make that thing less. Quite often as well, we will talk about length. The length of something, you can shorten that thing. You can make it shorter. Lengthen is to increase the length of something. You make something longer. You increase the length. You increase how long something is. And again, I suppose you can lengthen the time that you are doing something. Maybe in the morning you like to go for a swim at the local swimming pool. Maybe you will lengthen the amount of time that you spend doing that thing. Shorten something, lengthen something. To make something shorter, to make something longer. You might narrow something. So this might sound strange, because narrow can also describe the appearance of something, but also as an action. You can narrow something to reduce the width. So when we look at things normally, we normally have height, length, and width. So if you want to reduce the width of something, you make it narrow, or you make it narrower. So narrow can also be used as a verb, to make something less wide, to limit the width of something. So maybe a road is too wide, so you have to make it narrower. You will narrow that thing. Widen is the opposite. So maybe something is too narrow. Maybe it is too narrow with the width. You have to make it wider. So you widen something. You change that thing from narrow to wide. You widen that thing. You make it wider. Also, we can say that you widen something when you are increasing the area. So, for example, if you are searching for a missing person, maybe there is a person missing and you're trying to find them, maybe you are only looking in one place. Well, perhaps you need to widen the search. That means you are looking over a larger area. You increase the width. You widen the search. You are looking in a much larger area for something. Here's another one. Extend. And this is a thing that is often talked about when we are talking about making changes to our house. So here in the UK, a lot of people like to extend their house. They will make their house larger. Sometimes they will add something on the side, and sometimes they will add something on the top. They will extend the house. They will make their house larger. So to extend something is to make it longer. You extend something. You might extend your arm towards your friend because you want to shake their hand. Would you like to shake my hand? I will extend my arm towards you. So to reach out is also extend. To increase physical length or duration of time. So when we talk about time, it is possible to extend the time that you do something for. A good example would be this live stream. So imagine if my live stream was only 20 minutes long. Maybe I could extend my live stream to 1 hour or 2 hours. So you can extend something with time as well. You can extend the amount of time that you do something for. Something we quite often do when we want to express making something longer. And then, of course, we have the opposite, which is shorten. To shorten something is to make it less long. You make it shorter. To make something shorter, to decrease physical length or duration of time. So, of course, I can also make my live stream shorter. I can shorten my live stream. Maybe some people say, Mr. Duncan, 1 hour is too long. We can't sit here and watch you for 1 hour, Mr. Duncan. We have better things to do. I can't believe you would say that, but some people might. However, for those who find my lesson too long, you might want me to shorten the lesson. So instead of 1 hour, I will do 30 minutes. Maybe I will shorten my lesson. I will make it shorter. I will decrease the length. So length can be described as distance, height, width, and of course, depth as well, going downwards. And time as well. So all of those things can be lengthened or shortened, depending on the situation you are in. Maybe you need more time. Maybe you only require a little bit of time, so you want less time to do something. Here we go. I did mention this just deep. So you might go up, but you can also go down as well, to go down, maybe into the ground or under the ground. You go down deep. To deepen something, to make something less shallow. So when we think of shallow, we mean something that is not very deep. So maybe if your swimming pool is not very deep, you might need to deepen the pool, which means to make it deeper than it is now. To deepen something. To increase the physical depth of something. Something is deep. A thing is deep. It goes down a very long way. And we can measure how deep something is by measuring the depth. Depth is the measurement of how deep something is. To deepen something. Quite often with subjects as well. A subject can be deep. Maybe if you are talking about a subject that involves a lot of information, you might say that that particular subject is very deep. It is a deep subject. Here's a good one. This is one I could do with. This is one that I need quite often. To energize. If you energize, it means you make more lively. You introduce energy to something. Or, of course, you charge up something. Perhaps you have to charge up your phone. Maybe your phone is running low on power. So you have to energize your phone. You have to put power into your phone so it will work. To make more lively, to introduce energy. So energy can also be excitement. Maybe if you are excited about something, you can become energized. You might be excited about my new lessons that are coming up. You are excited. Here's another one. Fill. Fill. F-I-L-L. Fill. Introduce one thing into another. To fill something. For example, you might decide to fill your mug with water. So maybe you have some water and you fill the cup with water. To introduce one thing into another. So you are making changes because you are putting one thing into something else. You fill the cup with water. And then, of course, we have the opposite, which is empty. You empty something. So maybe I pour the water out. I pour the water out of the mug. I pour it away. It is gone. The cup is now empty. My mug has no water inside it, unfortunately. So to fill something, to introduce one thing into another, maybe you fill up your car with petrol, you fill in something, maybe you have to write something down on a piece of paper in a particular place, you fill in something. Maybe you have to fill in an application form, something you have to write on, you fill in that thing. And of course, if you are filling something, you are putting one thing into another. You are filling a bucket with water. And then the opposite, empty, to take one thing from another. You empty out something. You are emptying that thing. To empty your cup. To empty a bucket. You are removing the contents from that thing. Here's another one. Wet and dry. You might find sometimes if your clothes are wet, you will have to dry them. To dry something is to take away the moisture. You are taking away the moisture. You don't want that thing to be wet. You want it to be dry. So you will dry something in the sun. You can dry your clothes outside. Dry, take away the moisture. You are changing the feel of something from being wet to dry. You dry out something. So quite often here in the UK, if we are lucky during the summer, we can hang our washing outside and it will dry in the sun. You can also wet something as well. You can wet something. You introduce moisture. You moisten something. You moisten that thing. You dampen that thing to make something wet. Maybe you go out in the rain and you get wet. Maybe someone pours water over you. So they will take some water and they will pour the water over you. They wet you. You can wet something by making it wet. So as you can see, the thing that is wet may have been made wet by wetting it. You might wet the bed. If you are young, babies quite often will wet themselves. If you do a wee-wee in your nappy or your pants, you wet yourselves. That is a big change. And something that hasn't happened to me for a long time. Age. Here's another one. Change. We are talking about words that express change. Age is something that happens. Not only is it how old you are, but also the process as well, of aging. So everyone will age. You, me, him over there, everyone will age. To grow older, to mature, to make something older as well. A good example would be, I suppose, wine and cheese. Both of those things age. So you might decide that you want to make some nice cheese. You will put it somewhere in a dark, cool place, and over time that thing will age. So we are talking about a change that is taking place. And of course we have the opposite. If you want to make yourself look young, if you want to feel young, if you want to maybe wear some fashionable clothing to make yourself look younger, you might youthen yourself. To youthen is to feel or appear younger, to restore your youth. It isn't an easy thing to do, and there are a lot of people who promise that they can make you younger. To be honest, it's not easy. I always say that sometimes it is a good idea to age gracefully, with dignity. I think so. Although, unfortunately, it isn't easy to restore your youth from your appearance, but maybe the way you behave, maybe your character can be young. And we all know someone who has a very young character. They have a very youthful character. Here's another one. We will be going soon. Smarten something. You can smarten a thing. You can improve, renew, or make neater. You are improving the way something appears. You smarten something. Maybe your house is old and falling to pieces. Maybe the outside of the house needs painting. So you will smarten the house. You make it look better. To smarten something. Maybe your own appearance is not very good. Maybe you are always wearing old clothes. So one day you decide to go to the shops and buy some new clothes. You smarten your appearance. You improve your appearance. You renew your appearance. You make yourself neat and tidy. And then, of course, the opposite of smarten is ruin. So you ruin something. You make something look worse. So this is a negative change. To make something look worse is to ruin something. You make it worse. You degrade that thing. You destroy something. You ruin it. Something that looked nice is ruined. Something that had an attractive look is made to look unattractive. So we talk about making things smarter, nice looking, improved, renewed, and then we have ruin, which means to make things look worse, to destroy something, to make the appearance of something look not as good as it should. We have two more. Here's an interesting one. Morph. Ooh, I like that word, Mr. Duncan. That's a very nice word, Mr. Duncan. Can you use more words like that? Morph. To transform something. If you transform something, you change something. Something changes from one thing to another. We often use it in science. We can use it in scientific study. We often talk about things morphing. But more commonly, we will talk about changing the appearance of something, especially an image, maybe a photograph. Maybe you decide that you want to change the photograph of yourself to make it look better. You morph that particular thing. You alter an image. You change things to improve the appearance of a photograph or an image. And then we have metamorphose. Oh, Mr. Duncan, there is a nice word. To mutate, to alter, to become another thing. So one thing slowly changes into something else. You metamorphose. It is change. Quite often with animals, certain animals will change completely as they grow or develop from one state to another. I suppose the one I can think of straight away are frogs. Frogs start off with a small egg, and then they grow into tadpoles, and then they become semi-frogs, that is, frogs with tails, and then eventually the tail will disappear and they will become frogs. So that is a type of metamorphose. To metamorphose is to become another thing. Oh, very nice. By the way, this thing that's the background today, that is metamorphic rock. So that is a particular type of rock that has changed over the millions and millions of years. It has slowly changed due to the way the Earth has changed over millions of years, with heat, cold, heat, cold, more heat, more cold. And then, of course, we have pressure as well. So this type of rock you can see here on the screen is metamorphic rock. It is rock that has changed over the years. And you can see it looks rather nice. Finally, you can also shape something as well. To shape something, to make one thing out of another. You might take a piece of wood and you will shape the wood. You will do something to make the wood look different. You shape that thing. We are using it as a verb. So if you make a change to the appearance of something, especially if you are being very creative, perhaps you will create something from clay. You will make a sculpture or a pot or a vase. You shape something. You can also shape your own life as well. You make changes in your own life that shape the way your life goes. Sometimes we do. We have to make changes in our life because we want to shape our life, our career, the way our life is progressing. So you can shape something to make one thing out of another. You shape it. You create a shape or object by shaping it. Quite often when we are talking about people who are creative, artists, sculptors, they will often shape something to produce a work of art. And that, as they say, is that. We're coming towards the end already. I can't believe that we are almost at the end of today's live stream. I don't know about you, but it's gone by very quickly. Did you enjoy it? Did you like it? If you did, can you give me one of these, please? And it would be ever so nice. I will be so grateful. I will be very grateful, in fact. I am back on Sunday, and Mr. Steve will be with us on Sunday as well. So there is myself and also Steve on Sunday. There will also be some new English lessons. And these are the lessons that I've been making over the past few weeks. Now, I was going to put them on a new channel, But I did have some problems with that, because it is very difficult if you have more than one YouTube channel, because then you have to do certain things to maintain both of them. But I wanted to do them together, you see, but it would appear that you can't. So what I'm doing instead is I'm going to upload my new series of English lessons on this channel. You will see them appear over the next couple of days. Thank you very much for your company. Thank you for joining me today. I will be back with you on Sunday from 2 p.m. UK time. And yes, these will be available on Sunday. So next Sunday, I will start promoting my lovely merchandise. If you would like a Mr. Duncan mug, you can have one. If you would like a Mr. Duncan t-shirt, also, you will be able to have one as well. All of that coming on Sunday. See you very soon. Take care of yourselves. I hope you've enjoyed today's live stream. If you have, please give me a lovely like, and that will be ever so nice. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English, saying thank you for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed today's live stream. Give me a lovely like if you have. And of course, until the next time we meet, you know what's coming next. Yes, you do. Enjoy the rest of your Wednesday. Enjoy the rest of your week. And I will see you on Sunday. And don't forget to look out for those new lessons as well. Ta-ta for now. See you on Sunday. Thank you.